Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly create a striking, fun text design that you can use for almost any occasion. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl-N on Windows or Command-N on a Mac. You can make it any size you'd like. I'll make mine 1550 by 870 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Go to View and make sure Snap is not checked. Open your Horizontal Type tool and pick a font. I'm using Bank Gothic. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in the video description or project files. I'll make the point size 100, sharp, center text, and black for the color. Type out your text. To increase or decrease the space between all your characters, highlight your text and press and hold Alt on Windows or Option on a Mac as you press the left or right arrow keys on your keyboard. To increase or decrease the space or kerning between two characters, click between those characters and again press and hold Alt or Option as you press the left or right arrows. Ultimately, we want the characters to be as close as possible, but be optically balanced, meaning there could be a little space between them if you think they look better. Click on your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. Click inside the Transform and drag it to the upper left corner. Go to the bottom right corner of the Transform, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag it out to the right side of your document. Pressing Shift keeps the shape or aspect ratio of the text. Position it so the text is also flush with the top. Then press Enter or Return. Press T to open your Type tool, click on your document, and type out your second line of text. Adjust the kerning. Click on your Move tool and open your Transform tool. Move it to the left and drag the corner of the transform to the right. Adjust the size and position of the text so it's flush with the sides of the document and the bottom of the top text. Then press Enter or Return. Repeat this process for the other lines of text. If you need your document to have more space at the bottom, go to Image and Canvas Size. Change the inches to percent and type in a larger number for the height. Click on the top middle of the anchor grid and make the canvas extension color white. Then click OK. To see the entire document on your screen, press Ctrl or Command 0. As you can see, you have more space at the bottom if you need it. I'll go back to my original size. If you want to crop your image to the bottom of the text, open your Rectangular Marquee tool, click on the top left corner, and drag out a rectangular selection to the lower right corner of the bottom text. Then go to Image and Crop. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command D. Go to the top layer and Ctrl click or Command click on the large T to make a selection of the text. Go to the T on the next layer and press and hold Shift as you Ctrl-click or Command-click on it. This adds the selection of the shape of that text. Repeat this for the rest of your text layers. Click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with black. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selection with black. Invert your selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. To make sure it's inverted, press Q to see it as a quick mask. Press Q again to make it back into a selection. We'll save the selection by going to Select and Save Selection. When you see this window, click OK. We'll hide the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Open your Paint Bucket tool and click on the foreground color. Pick a color and click OK. Click on a white area to fill it with the color you picked. Go to the other white areas and click on them to fill them with the same color. Click back on the foreground color and pick another color. Click on various white areas to fill them in. Continue until you've filled all the white areas with colors you like. The last steps will be to make the areas of color fade to white at the top and bottom of the image. Open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Go to Alpha 1, which is the selection that we saved earlier. Control-click it or Command-click it to make it back into a selection. Open back the Layers panel and make a new layer. Click on the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the empty layer. Make the empty layer active and change its blend mode to Pin Light. Open your Gradient tool and click the Reflective Gradient icon. Click on the gradient bar and click on the lower left stop. Click the color box and type in 808080, which gives us 50% gray. Then click OK on both windows. Go to the middle of your image and press and hold Shift as you drag straight down to the bottom. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.